What would this message be if reading didn't exist? It would be a series of symbols without meaning. Reading is a skill that only humans have. Since it was invented by the Sumerians, it has now become a critical skill in our society. Yet reading is not innate. It takes many years of schooling to learn to read well. Why does it take so long? Because we have to learn to associate an orthographic form with a meaning and a sound. Let's look at what happens to our brain when we read, for example, a message. When you read coffee, posterior visual areas first analyze the visual features, such as straight and curved lines. Then, a posterior region of the left hemisphere recognizes single letters, letter combinations such as cough, fi, and then the whole word. Next, we associate the form coffee with its meaning. And this happens in the temporal area. And at the same time, we detect the sounds needed to say the word. And this happens in the parietal and then frontal areas. But if reading is not innate, how does our brain learn to read? The visual system used to recognize objects, animals, and faces develops a remarkable expertise in recognizing the shape of letters of any writing system, so refined that it can detect little differences between orthographic forms, like D from B or C from E. It's like learning to read a new alphabet. In the beginning, all the letters look like nonsensical symbols, but then we become trained to recognize them. Not only. A posterior area in the occipital temporal region activates with words in our alphabet. Therefore, this area will not activate for Japanese symbols, unless you know Japanese. Even the language areas become specialized in identifying the sounds of words. For example, take the word car and remove the letter C. What is left? R. This manipulation of sounds becomes easier when we learn to read. And the association between letters and sounds becomes stronger. But do different languages use the same brain networks? The answer is yes. Very different languages, such as English, Chinese, and Hebrew, which is read from right to left, use similar brain circuits, even if each language has specific activations. Let's take, for example, Italian and English. Italian is a regular language, and each letter almost always corresponds to one sound. Take the letter A. In Italian, is always read A. In casa, mamma, palla. In English, the letter A has different sounds, like in tap, came, ball. For this reason, temporal parietal areas are more activated in Italian, while in English, the occipital temporal areas are more involved to recognize the irregular combinations of letters. If a lesion, such as a stroke or a tumor, damages the occipital temporal area, patients can lose their ability to read. This disorder is called pure alexia, and patients read with a letter-by-letter procedure, like a child in his first years of schooling, because they have lost the ability to recognize the word as a whole. In these cases, areas near the lesion can compensate for the deficit and support reading. Sounds good!